My name is Jason Matthew, and I will be your MC for this morning's program. Today is Memorial Day, a day set aside to honor our fallen soldiers of any American war. We also honor our veterans and all of our men and women who are serving our country today so we can live in a free nation. We'll start by having the invocation by Pastor Marcia Collins of the United Church of Christ.
Let us pray. Creator God, we gather today to honor those who have served so faithfully. We know that is a contradiction in terms. It's a strong desire to live while being ready to face death. We are here to honor each one who has served, those who have died, and we also keep in our hearts and our minds the veterans who are with us today and those who are serving. We pray that you'll be with us as we celebrate each of their lives and the gift of democracy that they have paid a price that we can have. In your name we pray. Amen.
Please join me in pledging allegiance to our flag.
Detail, stand, push.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Next, we will have our national anthem sung by Paige Peters.
Detail, port, arm. Present.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Order, arm. Parade, rest.
Next, we'll have a reading by Donna Elliott.
Good morning. There are many stories to be told of World War II and the many soldiers who gave their lives for our country. This story is told by Tony Fords, an 82-year-old British man. The story begins when an American pilot on his 15th mission and his crew of 10 were hit by enemy fire during a daylight raid. The crew nursed the damaged plane back across the North Sea, trying to reach their base in Chelveston, England. The weather was poor, and when the plane broke through the crowds, they were over Sheffield, which was 80 miles northwest of their home base. Tony was almost 8 years old at the time and had joined a group of children playing in the schoolyard in Indiff Clark. It was an oasis of green surrounded by three sides of terraced houses and dense woodland. After 5 years of war, these boys were accustomed to hearing planes, but the sound of this aircraft wasn't right. The plane circled over the stretch of green, looking for a place to set the plane down. One airman frantically waved his arms at the boys. They waved back, thinking he was being friendly. Well, years later, Tony realized they were trying to get the children to clear the park so they could land their crippled plane. Years later, Tony told the Associated Press, "No one will ever tell me different. I killed those lads, and that will always stay with me." Tony has spent the best part of 7 decades tending the park, keeping it up to par, and hoping to have a memorial tribute for those American airmen. Tony finally got his wish, an aerial display befitting the young flyers who died that day instead of endangering the lives of those British children. The spectators watched as 4 U.S. fighters passed overhead. The names of those 11 American flyers were painted on the sides of the planes. One plane veered skyward in the missing man formation to honor the fallen. This story reminds us of how many stories we don't know about. Of all the soldiers who died back then and in the years ahead, fighting for our country and for peace. Thank you.
You know, today Ancestry.com and 23andMe is quite popular to find out our ancestry and where our inheritance came from. And yet for us today, what we're really focused on is the inheritance right here on this soil, in the United States of America. The people within our own family histories who have served and are serving our country. We would not be here today in the freedom to gather as we have it if it were not for the courageous men and women who signed up and even risked and gave their lives. So many died in the front lines of battle. They saw sights no human being should have to see. They smelled smells, and they even tasted the sweat of war. And yet they did it for you and me. And there are many others who served faithfully, perhaps not on the front line, to even those on the front line who were able to come home, often carrying wounds unseen to the human eye, carrying within them the stories and the memories of what they had been through that they did not want to burden their families with. Family members who just as much joined the services as those who put on uniform. The women and men and children at home who wait, who wonder, who pray, who dread, who dream of when they will see their loved ones again. The pictures we've seen on YouTube and the news of a service person coming and surprising a young person at their graduation or in their time of special events in their lives. So many people have served us, and those who have died because they were willing to look the beast in the eye, were willing to fight in order for us to have a free democracy. And we owe them a great debt, and we're here to honor them today. We're here to honor all people who have served and have consequently died. People who served in numerous ways that we sometimes cannot even imagine to support the front line. There are individuals who have died that we will never even know due to the secrecy of their missions. Those who were part of spying on collecting information, on caring to keep us safe, even up to today. There's those who have died today, yesterday, around the world who wear our uniform. We have families right now who are opening the door to uniform officials who come to give them the incredible, heartbreaking news of a loved one that has died. We stand and sit here in solidarity with these families to care for them, to embrace them, and to know that we owe them a debt too for the kind of service that they lead. We think of our veterans who are with us today, who are still living with us, and we know many of them, not all, but many carry incredible scars. Statistically, 22 a day of our veterans commit suicide. They come wounded, and we need to pay attention and care and honor them and to say that they make a difference in our lives, that what they went through, that we're even willing to hear it when they're ready to share it. May we pray for the protection of our living veterans, for our family members today, for each one who carries with them part of the uniform within their heart and within their soul, and that we are, as a community here, aware of people within our own families, of people who are on the front lines, of service members, of families that are next door who have a loved one in the service. Let us not forget them. Let us care for them as much as they're cared for on military bases, that they may know that we stand and sit with them, that we are part of them, and in gratitude for each one. For those who are willing and ready to die because they love America, they love the freedom, they love us, and that's why they serve.
If tomorrow all the things were gone I'd worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife, I thank my lucky stars to be living here today. Flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away.
Auxiliary sends two girls to Girl State at Eastern University. Today, Bailey Behrens and Caitlin Speckman will place a wreath at the unknown soldier's grave. Boy Scouts and Cub Scouts will each pay tribute with a wreath. Last year, death entered post-408's ranks. The American Legion lost Mr. Ray Clausen. Ray was a brother and a friend. His willingness to help however he could and his great sense of humor will be missed. Also in our community, we have lost veterans Obert Hilgendorf, Dale Mayotte, Russ Sadler, and Harold Tobinski. If you know of other veterans who we have lost, please quietly honor them along with those mentioned here today in a moment of silence. Thank you. Next, we'll have our benediction by Pastor Marcia Collins.
Let us pray. Creator God, we thank you for providing us life to be here. May we always remember that our veterans are a symbol of what is great in our nation, and we owe them so much for all they have done to ensure our freedom. Freedom to gather, freedom to think, freedom to act, freedom to be who we are. We pray for your blessings on each veteran, for comfort for those who grieve, and for those who are walking wounded. We pray for strength and courage, and we pray for a community that will let them know that they are incredibly precious to us and that we value their lives just as they value our lives in going into service. Pray that you will help us to live our lives to the fullest and preserve this democracy here at home in honor of all those who have served. Amen.